Guys, in this video, we want to look at the molecular basis of cancer, what proto-oncogenes are, what oncogenes are, what tumor suppressors are, etc. So basically, we are in this chapter, neoplasms, right, or neoplasia. So basically, for a growth which is abnormal, right, a tumor, so basically, you need some kind of trigger, some molecular basis, etc., right? So what happens here? First of all, you know that there is some kind of a chemical carcinogen or radiation or virus which are oncogenic, which can cause DNA damage, right? So basically carcinogens, okay, then there is DNA damage, right? In this case, what happens? Sometimes it tries to repair, sometimes it cannot repair. So what happens? Proto-oncogenes, these become oncogenes, okay? And some things are there in us which are protective, like tumor suppressors we have. These tumor suppressors actually try to protect us and suppress this tumor which is going to come up here. But sometimes even these can get mutated, right? So proto-oncogenes becomes oncogenes. Furthermore, the tumor suppressors get mutated, so the work of the oncogenes cannot be corrected, right? Then you have the apoptosis suppression. Apoptosis regulating genes are also not going to work. So these cells become immortal. So all these are the molecular basis of neoplasia, guys. Finally, what happens? There is uncontrolled cell division, clonal expansion and tumor progression. Right, guys? This much did you understand? So basically, did you understand that what a proto-oncogene is? Proto-oncogene is something that can get converted into an oncogene. Proto-oncogene can get converted into an oncogene. An oncogene is going to cause cancer. To protect us from this oncogene, our body has tumor suppressors or something called as anti-oncogene. Anti-oncogene is going to protect us from this oncogene, right? But in some cancers, even these can get suppressed. So there will be mutation in these tumor suppressor genes. And then you have the apoptosis regulation. So when there is uncontrolled division, etc., the cell tries to undergo apoptosis, and normally the cell has to undergo apoptosis, but this also will be abnormal. So there won't be apoptosis and these cells become immortal. So that is how the cancer happens, right? So first of all, if they ask molecular basis of cancer, you will have to explain all this. The carcinogens like virus, radiation, chemicals, etc., which are going to cause DNA damage, convert the proto-oncogenes into oncogenes, mutate the tumor suppressors, and also cause problem in this apoptotic genes, okay? So what we will do now, we will look at the proto-oncogenes. So what are these proto-oncogenes? We need to look at the proto-oncogenes. So many types of proto-oncogenes are there, like growth factors, receptors for growth factors, cytoplasmic signal in transduction proteins, nuclear transcription factors, cell cycle regulated proteins, even cyclins. All these are going to be proto-oncogenes. Even cyclins are proto-oncogenes. Look at the examples of proto-oncogenes. You have cis. Guys, pay attention here. We have just marked a few important things that you can focus on. Under growth factors, you can try to remember plasma derived, platelet derived growth factor beta. Example you have is the cis gene, okay? It's a proto-oncogene. Cis is a proto-oncogene. It can lead to glioma, sarcomas. Then you have the transforming growth factor alpha, okay? So under growth factor, you can mention two growth factors, platelet derived growth factor beta and transforming growth factor alpha, okay? Then under the receptor for growth factors, you can mention RET gene. Right, for multiple endocrinal neoplasia syndromes, right? Remember, it is RET. RET is what? Receptor, proto-oncogene, receptor for growth factors. That is the type, okay? Then, coming to the cytoplasmic signal transduction proteins. So, the proto-oncogenes can have so many types, guys. So, the third type here we are looking at is the type that makes the cytoplasmic signal transduction protein, like the RAS and ABL-BCR. Remember, RAS and ABL-BCR. You have seen ABL-BCR in CML, chronic myeloid leukemia. Remember, right? CML causes CML. So this is a cytoplasmic signal transduction protein, non-growth factor receptor tyrosine kinase. Okay. Moving on, guys, what are we looking at currently? Proto-oncogenes. We have finished the types, three types we have finished already. Growth factors, receptor for growth factors, cytoplasmic signal transduction proteins, where we saw RAS and ABL-BCR. Now let us move on to the nuclear transcription factors. So we are going deep into the cell now. So nuclear transcription factors, we have the CMYC, that is MYC you can say, because of translocation there can be Burkitt's lymphoma. And neuroblastoma can be there because of the amplification. Moving on to the cell cycle regulatory proteins, cyclins and CDK4. So translocation, overexpression, amplification can result in a lot of carcinomas. Okay. So guys, this table was quite huge. At least remember what are the examples of proto-oncogenes. CIS, RET, RAS, ABL-BCR, MYC, cyclin, CDK4. So if they ask proto-oncogenes examples, you will say CIS, RAT, RES, ABL-BCR, MYC, cyclin, CDK4. Excellent. Very good. So now let's move on to understand what tumor suppressors are. Okay. So guys, basically a proto-oncogene becomes an oncogene, right? Proto-oncogene becomes an oncogene and it tries to make the cell divide a lot and it gives a lot of growth factor and the cells try to divide. But then some rescuer comes, okay? His name is tumor suppressor. He comes and says, no, I will not allow this tumor to grow. So it's a tumor suppressor. Unfortunately, these tumor suppressors itself get suppressed, right? Then only the cancer can grow. So who are these tumor suppressors who get suppressed? That is what we are going to look at in this table, okay? So in this, what you have to focus on, because the gene, it's here, the tumor suppressor genes are here. These are also called as anti-oncogenic genes, tumor suppressors or anti-oncogenic. They are their location and the associated tumors. Pay attention here to the important ones. Carcinoma breast, okay? BRCA1 and BRCA2. BRCA1 is on chromosome 17, BRCA2 is on chromosome 13. Okay, so important ones at least you learn. So carcinoma breast, carcinoma ovary, you have the BRCA1 and BRCA2 genes. So they are on the chromosome 17 and 13. So mutation of these can cause the carcinoma breast, carcinoma ovary. So one example of tumor suppressor you already got. Now see, tumor suppressor PP, right? So remember P53. So P53 is a tumor suppressor. P53 is what? It's a tumor suppressor. It will cause lot of cancers, okay, if it gets suppressed. Then you have RB gene, retinoblastoma gene, which seems to be on the chromosome 13, if it gets mutated, retinoblastoma. NF, neurofibromatosis 1 and 2, if there is a problem with it, neurofibromatosis type 1, type 2. Where is neurofibromatosis where is it? It is on the plasma membrane. Okay. Now what about WT1 and 2? WT is nothing but Wilms tumor, guys. Wilms tumor 1 and 2 gene. This is actually a good thing. Okay. Wilms tumor 1 and 2, right? They are tumor suppressors. Unfortunately, they'll also get mutated in cancer because of all these carcinogens and that can lead to Wilms tumor. Wilms tumor is something that will affect what? The kidney, right? Then VHL, von Hippel-Lindau gene. Von Hippel-Lindau gene on chromosome 3 gets mutated or affected and causes renal cell carcinoma. So what and all you learned now? RB gene, P53, BRCA, von Hippel-Lindau, Wilms tumor, neurofibromatosis. So many tumor suppressors you learned the names. Very good. So you have learnt what and all tumor suppressors, retinoblastoma, then P53, then BRCA, then von Hippel-Lindau, then Wilms tumor 1 and 2, neurofibromatosis. So many genes name you learnt. Very good. Now we will do one thing. Let's compare oncogenes with anti-oncogenes. So what is oncogene? Oncogene will try to create the tumor. Anti-oncogene is tumor suppressor. It will try to suppress the tumor. Okay. So pay attention here. Oncogene is mutated form of normal proto-oncogene. Are you able to see? So basically, oncogenes are mutated forms of normal proto-oncogenes. The genetic abnormality is mutation, like point mutation, translocation, amplification, overexpression, retroviral insertion, DNA damage. All this can happen. What is the major action? It allows cell proliferation by increased growth promotion and pathway. So, you know, it will create lot of growth factors, lot of receptor for growth factors, lot of transcription factors, lot of cytoplasmic signal transduction proteins. Cytoplasmic signal transduction proteins it will create the cell cyclins, the CDK4, some problem. So, lot of cell proliferation will happen. That is what it wants to do. It wants to allow cell proliferation. Level of action, it can be either on the cell surface, for the receptors, in the cytoplasm, etc. Now, what are the major types? You have already seen this. Growth factors, growth factor receptors, cytoplasmic signal proteins, nuclear transcription proteins, cell cycle regulator proteins. You have already seen the examples. Growth factors, you saw cis gene, platelet-derived growth factor, transforming growth factor. In receptors, you have seen RET. Cytoplasmic signal proteins, you saw RAS, BCR, ABL. Nuclear transcription proteins, you saw MYC, cell cycle regulatory proteins, you saw cyclins and CDKs. So that completes the entire thing about oncogene. You have understood oncogene. Now let us move on to the comparison with anti-oncogene, that is the tumor suppressor. So what will tumor suppressor try to do? It will try to suppress the cell proliferation. So it is a suppressor gene. It will try to stop the proliferation of the cell. At what levels will it work? Same thing. Cell surface, cytoplasm, nucleus. It will try to work at all these levels. What are the examples? You already saw RB, P53. Then you saw BRCA, von Hippel-Lindau, Wilms tumor, neurofibromatosis. Also, that's what BRCA. It's already written here. So you have seen all these anti-oncogene, guys. So you have understood the differences between oncogene and anti-oncogene. Basically, oncogene tries to push the cells to grow a lot, and anti-oncogene tries to say, no, let us stop. So it is a tumor suppressor. So what did you understand? Like, if it is a car, right? The basic example they give you is a car. Now, oncogene is like an accelerator. Anti-oncogene is like a brake. So the car, if it has to be pushed to go fast, you need an anti-oncogene, and also you need the brake to fail, right? So that you cannot control the car. So both of these have to, you know, be there for a cancer. So oncogenes, which will promote the cell growth, and the mutation of an anti-oncogene so that there is no tumor suppressor. Okay. So guys, so basically what this diagram is representing is, this is a normal cell. Then it becomes a mutated cell because of DNA damage. Then it becomes a cancerous cell. Lot of cell proliferation, and all these red lines you see around, this is angiogenesis, so that there is blood supply to these tumor cells and they are able to have tumor progression. Okay, so angiogenesis also is one of the things that this tumor requires. So that was about neoplasia, molecular basis, and also about proto-oncogenes, about oncogenes, about tumor suppressors, which are anti-oncogenes. Okay, that's all for now in this video. We will meet you in the next video. Bye-bye.